paper kind of a reference. I don't care if you have aspects on it throughout the year, but I think it gives you different reasons that you can use as a proof. And so it gives you like this definition, So if you have that scenario, then you can use that exact definition of proof. So, and I will show you how to use it. It's how the properties will do it here yesterday. It's got some theorems that are both that we are going to be learning and some cautions that we've learned so far. Okay. And so you might want to keep that kind of handy as you get started with these proofs. Yesterday we did the algebraic, and we're going to do a little bit more of those today. We're going to incorporate some geometry in there also. We did the worksheet where we had to write conjectures, and I told you guys that when you write a conjecture, you want it to be purposeful, okay? And I gave an example, you know, if you're going to have a discussion with your parents about the shorts you wear at school, the fact that they're red usually probably doesn't come into play. It's, you know, how short they are, or how high the holes are, or whatever, okay? And so you want it to be purposeful. So if, like in this first example, you're told that BD bisects angle ABC, what would you get a meaning for that? The fact that BD bisects the angle. My reason for that, AB equals PQ, PQ equals XY. AB equals XY. Okay, and so what am I going to do with that? Now, you can use the transitive property with congruence as well as equality. Okay? Use either one. Now, one we did not talk about much, but it's on your sheet, is if I told you that PQ is congruent to RS, okay? And, if PQ is congruent to RS, then equals RS. You can go from congruence to equality, equality to congruence by the definition of congruent segments or angles, whatever you happen to be working. Okay? They kind of mean the same thing, but they really don't. Congruence is talking about how the two segments are the same. Equality talks about how their measures are equal. You can't add, subtract, multiply, and divide if you're in congruence. Substitute in congruence. It has to be in equality. Okay? So this definition allows me to go from one to the other, and you'll see why that's important here in just a few minutes. Okay? That's another one of the definitions on the sheet. Okay. AD bisects BC. What could I get from that? implies that we sin. You could probably say either one of those there. You could say that easy and be scared can ruin, or you could say that it is a midpoint. I would probably take either one of those there. Just go back and look at the definition of bisector. It's a line of segment or a plane that intersects a segment at its midpoint, making two congruent parts. Okay? So ED is congruent to BC, and that by the definition of segment bisector. I would say D is the midpoint. Probably would depend on where you want to go with it, honestly. Okay. Ray, BD bisects angle ABC. Angle 2 is congruent to angle 3. I want to prove angle 1 is congruent to angle 3. Okay. So here's a full-fledged proof. Alright? Now, in these types of situations, you want to look at the deal that obviously that's going to be the first step. You also want to mark the picture with the information you're given and try to figure out how you're going to get from the given to the proof. Okay? And so let's flip chart out this group now. So I come over here, and I know that angle 2 and 3 are congruent, yes? I also am told that BD bisects angle ABC. What can I get from that? What can I get from the fact that BD bisects angle ABC? Okay, 1, angle 2 are ABD and angle 6, yes. So those two are congruent. So these two are congruent, right? And I know that these two are congruent, yes? That's what that means for all three. They're all three going to be congruent to each other, okay? So I have to state that angle 1 is congruent to angle 2. And what allows me to say that? Not 1 and 2. 1 and 2, these two being congruent, comes from the fact that B and B bisects A and C. So what would my reason be? Bisect. Definition of angle bisect, right? And that just says bisect an angle, but it breaks it into two congruent parts, yes? Okay. So you would say that angle 1 is congruent to angle 2 by definition of angle bisect. Okay. So from this statement right here, I got this. 1, 2, congruent. I'm given that 2 and 3 are congruent. So if I look here, I've got 1 congruent to 2, I've got 2 congruent to 3. So what can you say? Angle 1 is congruent to angle 3. And what's that going to be for? See how it connects? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 1 to 3, right? 1 congruent to 2, 2 congruent to 3, 1 congruent. Okay, so there's just a little algebra and a geometric input. Okay, I'm going to skip the next one. Go to your other paper and come back to this one. On your paper. Okay, this one that we had yesterday. Okay, in this problem, you can feel this, that AB is congruent to CD. And we're told that AB equals 2x minus 5, and CD equals 4x minus 13. And all of that is feet. Okay? Now, I don't even have a picture. Really, the only thing I need to know is the fact that AB and CD are congruent. Because then they give the information about the measure of AB and the information about the measure of CD, okay? So what do you think is going to end up happening? Okay, ultimately, we're going to set those two equal to each other, right? Because AB can be replaced, right? if theta equals complex, which is called substitution, right? You cannot use substitution when you have two things that congruent to each other. You can only use substitution when you have two things that are equal to each other. Okay? So I've got to change this congruent statement into an equality statement. We talked about that just a second ago. What allows me to go from congruence to equality? 2x plus 7 equals negative 5. That is subtraction, right? Then what? Subtract again. So negative 2x equals negative 14. And then by subtraction. And then what? 5.
That's what I was saying.
Picture, it says D at the midpoint of BC. What can I get from that? To get the midpoint of BC. AB and BC are congruent, right? Okay, definition of midpoint allows this data. I'm also told in my given that AB and BD are congruent, yes? So what's true about all three? They're all congruent to each other. AB is congruent to DC. AB is congruent to DC. And I want that because those are the ones I know information about, right? I mean, that kind of helps you a little bit there, too, right? And so what's my reason for that? For instance. Okay, so what's my next step going to be? I want to change it to equals so that I can then substitute. So, AB equals DC, that is definition of congruent segment time. And so now that I have an equal, I can go and substitute what I know, right? I can replace AB with 6x minus 4, and I can replace DC with 2x plus 12, that's substitution. To